In honor of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., the Lacrimous Leopard leaders have prepared for you a brief history of his life and legacy.
Martin Luther King Jr. grew up in a big house in Atlanta, Georgia. He lived with his mother, his father, his big sister Christine, and his little brother Alfred. Martin's father was a minister, and his mother was a teacher.
Martin liked to ride his bike. He liked to play baseball, football, and basketball too.
Martin liked to sing in his father's church and listen to his father use big words as he preached to the people.
Martin liked to play with all the children in the neighborhood. Some of the children were white and some were black. They all liked to play together.
When the children got older, they could no longer play together. Black children and white children were not allowed to play together. They could not go to the same school or drink from the same watering fountain.
This made Martin very sad. His mother said, "Some people do not treat black people fairly." Martin didn't understand why there were signs that said, "White only," at some parks, restaurants, pools, and even schools.
Martin wondered what he could do to change this. When he grew up, he would try to help teach people to treat others fairly and make the world a better place to live.
While Martin was growing up, he loved to read. In school, he worked hard. He graduated early and started college when he was only 15 years old.
At college, Martin decided to become a minister like his father. He wanted to use big words that his father used to make people feel good inside. Martin wanted to talk to people about the way they treated each other.
In college, Martin met Coretta Scott, a young woman who studied music. Soon, they were married. Martin worked hard at college and studied in graduate school. Then he was called Dr. King.
After college, Dr. King became the pastor of a church in Montgomery, Alabama. One day, a black woman named Rosa Parks was arrested. She broke a law because she sat in the white-only part of a bus.
Dr. King wanted to change the law that made black people sit in the back of the bus. He led a peaceful protest. He said that black people should not ride in the buses until the law was changed.
For more than a year, the buses were almost empty, and the bus companies lost money. Soon the law was changed, and the white-only signs came down. All people could sit on the bus wherever they wanted.
Dr. King moved to Atlanta and led peaceful protests against laws that were not fair. He became famous and gave many speeches.
Many people joined his freedom marches to change the unfair laws.
One day, a man who did not know about being fair to others shot and killed Dr. King. We will remember Martin Luther King Jr. He was a brave man who had dreamed that every day, everyone would live together in peace.
A day that will forever be remembered, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. delivered his iconic I Have a Dream speech in front of the Lincoln Memorial. Lacrimous fifth graders bring to you part of that special address.
I Have a Dream, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.
I say to you today, my friends, that even though we face the difficulties of today, and tomorrow, I still have a dream. It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream.
I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out of the true meaning of creed. We will hold these truths to be self-evident, and all men are created equal.
I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. I have a dream that one day even the state of Mississippi, a state sweltering with the heat of injustice, sweltering with the heat of oppression, will be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice.
I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character.
I have a dream today.
I have a dream that one day, little black boys and black girls will be able to join hands with little white boys and white girls as sisters and brothers. I have a dream today.
I have a dream that one day, every valley shall be exalted. Every hill and mountain shall be made low. The rough places will be made plain, and the crooked places made straight. And the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together.
This is our hope. This is the faith that I go back to the South with. With this faith, we will be able to hew out of the mountain of despair a stone of hope. With this faith, we will be able to transform the jangling discords of our nation into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood.
With this faith, we will be able to work together, to pray together, to struggle together, to go to jail together, to stand up for freedom together, knowing that we will be free one day.
This will be the day when all of God's children will be able to sing with new meaning. My country is 'tis the sweet land of liberty. Of thee I sing. Land where my father died, land of the pilgrim's pride, from every mountainside.
So let freedom ring from the prodigious hilltops in New Hampshire. Let freedom ring from the mighty mountains in New York. Let freedom ring from the hidings Owl Haines of Pennsylvania. Let freedom ring from the snow-capped Rockies of Colorado.
Let freedom ring from the curvaceous slope of California. But not only that, let freedom ring from Stone Mountain of Georgia. Let freedom ring from Lookout Mountain of Tennessee. Let freedom ring from every hill in Molehill of Mississippi.
From every mountainside, let freedom ring.
And when this happens, we will allow freedom to ring. When we let it ring from every village and every hamlet, from every state and every city, we will be able to speed up that day when all of God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, will be able to join hands and sing in the words of the old Negro spiritual.
Free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last.
When you dream, dream big, as big as the ocean.
Everyone has a dream. What's your dream, Lachimus Leopard?
When you dream, it might come true.
I have a dream for everybody to work together and to let the oceans be less polluted.
I have a dream that everyone would be treated fairly.
I have a dream that war would end and peace would be around the world.
I have a dream to sheep and boy.
I have a dream that racism would end and people would be in peace together.
I have a dream to use less energy.
I have a dream to do whatever I want.
I have a dream that everybody gets treated equally.
I have a dream that the ocean becomes unpolluted.
I have a dream to see a Komodo dragon and a box jellyfish.
I have a dream to be a professional ballet dancer.
I have a dream we can plant more trees and stop cutting down as many.
I have a dream to become a flying kitty cat with a unikitty.
My dream is to get in the NFL.
I have a dream that everyone is happy and healthy.
And when you laugh, be sure to laugh out loud, 'cause it will carry all your cares away. And when you see the beauty all around and in yourself, and it will help you feel okay. And when you pray for strength to help you carry on, and when the troubles come your way. And when you dream, dream big, as big as the ocean blue.
when you dream it might come true. When you dream, dream big.